When Daddy does a wee and does a shower,
when he gets out, he just always leaves on the light and I have to keep turning it all off.
Leela.
My name is Arthur.
I'm Rafe and I'm 5.
And I'm Brian and I'm 54.
54? I thought you were 80.
Yeah.
What is climate change?
If I don't know what it is.
I know what exactly it is. It's a storm.
When you leave the lights on in a room, what do you think happens to the energy?
Goes away.
Where does it go?
In the bin.
How do we talk to 5-year-olds about climate change so that, you know, it doesn't fall into this area of being very depressing or create anxiety in them?
We have to be careful to balance that sense of concern, which we should be feeling about the environment, with also a sense of hope as well. The first thing is to start the conversation. And one way of doing that is to actually ask children questions about what they know, you know, and listen to them and their ideas.
What do you know about electricity?
Electricity powers stuff on.
I don't know.
I know that it stings and it comes out of clouds.
Fair enough.
Why do we need electricity?
So we can make things work.
To watch TV.
More important things than your entertainment?
I don't know, you answer.
Oh, okay, so what about cooking your food?
What uses a plug?
The bulb.
Bulb doesn't use a plug. Oh, of course it uses a plug.
If we don't have electricity, nothing will work. No one will be happy ever again.
Okay.
Where do you think it comes from?
I don't know.
The electricity station. It goes through the pylons to everyone's houses. Even here, because you're videoing me, and those cameras are powered by electric.
Around 20% of the UK's CO2 emissions, the gases that are actually contributing to climate change, come from domestic energy use. So concentrating on how you're using energy in the household is a really good way to start your environmental behaviour.
Is the Earth getting hotter or colder?
Say it.
Ooh, what does that mean?
Hotter.
We're doing bad things and we're making it warm.
Things that are bad for the planet.
The car smoke.
That is very bad.
Do you think cow's burps are a lot worse for the environment than cow farts?
Ew! Mum burps and mum even farts.
Oh, now we're getting down to nitty-gritty.
Why do people worry about polar bears?
Because they have sharp teeth and they're really strong.
Why is it important to look after where the animals live?
So the animals live and they don't die.
That's the enormity of it, isn't it? It's such a huge issue that it feels, on first glance, overwhelming.
So, yes, you have to be honest, you have to accept that there is a problem, but there's something that people are doing about it, and there's something that we can all do about it. We can all be involved.
What do you do at home to help look after the planet?
Throw trash in the bin and not waste electricity.
Good.
Turn off the electrics, turn off the lights when you're going to a different room, but we normally leave them on.
The home is really important, isn't it? Because it's the context that they're in contact with the most. Mm. So it's really quite nice to think about how they appreciate the resources in their home.
Can you think of a way that TV could use less energy?
Do not watch it so much.
Mm-hmm. How much energy do you think the fridge uses? 11.
11, yeah. A windmill!
Do you know what they're used for?
For wind power and for flour. That rhymes.
Moving into his poetic phase.
What do you think it sounds like?
It's actually a joy to hear them talking about these things. There's still gaps there, which is what you'd expect, isn't it? I mean, they're 5 years old.
Perhaps there's a sense that we're in a bit of a strange place at the moment. You know, here are these five-year-olds, and how can we prevent them from becoming the next generation who've got this eco-anxiety?
When you empower a child to think that they can act, that's actually quite a good way of moderating some of that concern so it doesn't turn into anxiety.
Can I go?
Yeah, you're done.
Okay, come on.
Okay, thank you. Good job, Arthur.